They're going to exceed the glory of the Lord. So if you don't know that, know it today and separate yourself for God so that you may be chosen to reveal the glory of God. Who wouldn't want to be in that glory? But many times you don't want to do what it takes for that glory to be revealed. It is a shame. So God is saying he wants his glory to start being revealed in the church.
Amen.
And that's a confirmation of this message. We've seen it. Today we've seen the glory of God among us.
His
praise is within us. I praise and exalt God for the choir. Thank you for separating yourself for God. There is a sign that shows you are not doing things by yourself. There was nothing to force. Christ has led us. The Lord and the Holy Spirit. And we've offered the praise and worship. And they are all accepted before God. I felt it. And I've heard apostles saying this. And thank you, God, for accepting our praise. Go with me in the book of Zechariah, chapter 1, and verses 3. Someone is.
Therefore,
tell the people,
This is what the Lord Almighty says. Return to me.
Declares the Lord Almighty.
And I will return to you.
Says the Lord Almighty. Zacharias, chapter 1, verses 3. For someone in Uganda, I don't know. If you were there, you can help us also.
Zakaria,
praise God. So God wants to reveal the glory of the church to be revealed. He wants his glory to be in the church. So now his glory to be in the church, he has to be in the church. Someone made a statement that the churches of born again are many, but there is no Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is not given any chance to minister to them. They minister according to the flesh. They minister according to their knowledge, not being led by the Spirit. And the only chance they give to the Holy Spirit is to talk about him when they are saying, may the praise of our Lord Jesus Christ and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit. That is when you only hear the Holy Spirit being talked about. But all other things are done after their will. It is a shame. Now, God is saying he wants the glory of the church. And if the glory of the church is to be there,
God has to be there.
Katonda mwena inokubao.
And if God is to be in the church,
Katonda wabao wakubu kanisa.
He's saying,
Agamba,
you are the one to take the first step to turn to me.
Gwa inokutwale daleri chuko dejeundi.
After you turning to me,
umaro chuko kuta jeundi.
I will also turn to you.
Nange yakuma ujiwe.
So it is us to turn to God.
Fetu inokuchuka today katonda.
And then God will turn to us.
Katonda na yedu watia deje tuli.
Because God did not move or go anywhere.
Kuba katonda taliko yalaga.
It's only us who move.
Fetu wata mle tumulekao.
Scriptures are very clear, the God we serve does not change.
Ebyandi kwa bichirambi kaburunyi ni katonda kwetu weleza tachuka.
Though he changes the ways he deals with men.
Ne wankuba dachu sengeri jakuragana muna abantu.
Amen. So we have to turn to God. And if we turn to God, He will turn to us. In this month we have a theme that we should separate ourselves ultimately. Intimacy. What's that? Intimacy separation for God? Separate? Intimacy.
Separation for
intimacy.
Separation for intimacy. God bless you so much. So, you separate yourself. In intimacy. Intimacy. Not just a matter of you separating yourself. Anyone can separate. The same way anyone can fast. Muslims do fast. Even the Catholics. Actually, they do. We have the charismatics. Who fellowship like born again. Praise the Lord. So, separating ourselves. It should be having love in it. And willingness. Not just because we talked about it. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So if you were the one, we are the one to take the first step. Some of us have already taken that step. Others have not taken it. But for those who have not taken it, let us take it today. For the glory of the church to be revealed. To the nations. Even to fellow born again churches. They say be a change you want to see. So in the church,
Mukanisa,
we have to be the change God wants to see. We are the people
Feban
who are going to reveal the glory of the church. Amen. So let us return to God fully. Let us forget about other ways that we have been taking. The Bible says that many are the plans of men. But it's God who directs their feet. So let's allow God to direct our feet to where He's directing us. I'm telling you, this God I'm talking about has no any evil intentions. Each and every plan He has for our lives is good and it is us who benefits. So all we have to do is to submit under His will. And definitely His work shall be revealed. And when the glory of God comes, it comes in a package. It comes in a package. Things that come from God, they don't come alone. They come with some things attached. The same way beauty does not come alone. For you to be called beautiful, you have to be nice looking.
You
have to be wise.
have to be smart.
You must have a good scent in your mouth.
That
people might not say she would be beautiful, but
omuntu omulungi tebateekako naye.
A beautiful person, they don't add but.
Naye obulungi buliko ebibuwerekera.
But beauty is followed by other things, other characteristics.
Ebyo bitakubaako.
If those are not following your beauty,
agenda kulaba bulungi.
Nobody will see your beauty.
Amen. So kati teri kiberi Katonda nekijja nga kiri kyokka.
Nothing comes from God and it comes alone.
Bwe tuba bakubeera Katonda bw'abanga agenda kujja gye tuli.
If God is to come to us,
agenda kujja na buli kimu kye twetaaga.
He's going to come with all that we need.
Kubanga okujja kwayagala kulaba kitiibwa kye mu kanisa.
He's coming, he wants to see his glory back in the church.
Nga tetukyerwanira ntalo.
Without us fighting our own battles.
Tulina entalo eziri minor.
We have minor battles.
Entonotono.
The battles that are minor.
Ng'okwambala obwambazi z'obulungi mulirwana wakuwala.
Just dressing well, your neighbor hates you.
Kati naawe ove waka.
So you also come.
Ng'oyambadde bulungi.
Dressing.
Oyite w'oyongera omulungi.
That you might pass and hurt them.
Weyingira mu lutalo lutakwata.
You join the battle that you shouldn't be for.
Oyitalina na bifaamu.
That has no results.
Katonda tafunamu.
So God is not getting.
Naawe tejja kusasula mukweraga.
Nobody pays you in your bragging.
Okuleka okubanga Katonda bakutuliya alaba owamalala.
Apart from when God sees you, he sees a proud man or woman.
Kati twagala tubenga newe twambala obwambazi.
We want to be, even if that we put on.
Twambala kuwesa Katonda kitiibwa.
We want to dress up to honor God.
Tukolera ng'ekitiibwa kirabisibwa.
Where we work from, the glory of God manifested.
Abantu batandika okwebuuza.
People might say,
asalira wa?
Where does she fellowship from?
Bamusongere ngosabira na musukulu hall.
They will always point them into a school hall.
Nga waliwo ekigambo ekyo.
There is a word.
Kubanga kama tatula mu nyumba zisimbiddwa ba mikono
gya. God does not sit in houses constructed by the hands of man.
Katonda tanoonyanga ko kitiibwa mu bizimbe bisimbiddwa.
God seeks not glory from the
ekitiibwa kya Katonda gwenange ffe tukyetisse.
Me and you are carriers of the glory of
God. Katika tubeera betisaba
luti. Let us be good carriers.
Otambulenga nawe ya kikumenya.
That you might move and you feel
it
has increased.
Whenever
you have the glory of God,
at
work they call you born again. She only understands God. When you are at home, there is a difference. The children of Israel made a prayer when they were in Israel. The difference between an Israelite and an Egyptian. That prayer must move with us.
There must
be a distinction between a born again and non-born again.
Take it more deeper, you that fellowships in righteousness
palace, you must have a distinction.
Our
church members are not more concerned about them. That is why if you bring what they do in their churches,
Katonda,
God has given us a different vision.
For
17 years down the road, I do not know where Apostle was when she received the vision,
but I she revealed it well
and we understand it.
Erecho mukama ayongero chimwero
ati may God give her more righteousness.
Buli gota tegera kwolese bogenda kubula.
Whenever you don't understand the vision, you will go astray.
Nechitipa cha Katonda tichila lisi.
And the glory of God will never be manifested upon your life.
Kati tetukola nga church endala bwesi kololo kuba nabo balokole.
We do not do like other churches do because they are also born again.
Buli mukolese a righteousness
palace. Are under the vision of righteousness palace.
Nechigamba balai bachiwulira kale nabo bachikole naye lero chise waffe.
When others hear this one, okay, let them do it.
Katonda ayagala kitiibwa kya kanisa kirabisi.
God wants the glory of God to be manifested. Whether you are an usher, whether you are a singer, whether you are a preacher, whatsoever you do, always show yourself and share the glory. And God will appreciate you when His glory is manifested. It might be a class, but we cannot fail to thank the people that prepare it. It changes, and it looks like not a class. This place will have
changed.
If you are an intercessor, do what manifests the glory of God in the Church of Righteousness Palace. Let other churches, our brothers and sisters, find meet you and consult you, seeing your distinction and them. And when they consult you, get a chance of revealing the secret to them. They shall not fail to do it. There must be a difference. If the glory came down, there are things people will not witness on you. They shall be seeing God. Why do they still see you? That is why God says
he
wants His glory. We are grown. You crown and
grind.
You find stagnant water and you play in it. You listen to whatsoever doesn't concern you. The phone might quench all the glory of God from you if you don't carefully handle it.
Zino.
Those phones, they are code wise.
Smartphones.
They are smart. Sometimes you type the word and it changes the word. Maybe you now if you are hurry in sending the word, seeing the message you sent is not the phone sent other words instead of the words you meant. So we shouldn't be smartphones to God. We will not do our will from what God wants us to do.
Amen.
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 We shall do the will of God. Now He wants to see His glory in the church.
Amen.
The secular people say they dress to kill.
Mm-hmm.
What do you dress to do? Do you dress to kill as the secular people? We dress to honor God. Why do you dress the way you dress to come to church? Or you just dress whatsoever you see? Who will say a word about me? It's true, nobody will say anything about you. But in that not telling you anything, it shall not refuse us from thinking or divert us from thinking.
Amen. So,
let us do all that we do for the glory of God. The Bible says, he that is faithful in the
little,
God entrusts them with bigger things. We are in
the
journey, we want to buy our own land. How are we handling Mirembe Primary School? Children of God will come. They call them incense.
So
you that is blessed to do something, the children of God to fellowship in this place,
do
it with all your intellect, with all your strength, for the glory of God to be manifested. Ministers come here at 8:30. They pray for 30 minutes for the glory of God.
I'm
in love with the way righteousness policies forward in these days. And most thing that angers, the Bible says, if you are warm and not warm, cold and not cold, God will spit you, will vomit you. Let us take a keen caution.
Amen.
Amen.
So, tugame bitiba Katonda bwachiko kujja jetuli.
If God turns to come back to us, he doesn't come alone.
He comes with prosperity.
Ajja n'obugagga.
Amen. Because the glory cannot be revealed without prosperity. If you read about the church in the Old Testament, of how they used to purify it, to design it, to decorate it with gold, silver, and expensive stuffs. So the church needs a lot. So God will not come alone. Because this time He is turning to us for His glory to be revealed.
And
He's going to turn with the prosperity. You have to put on wealth. You have to live well. You have to look good. And the church of God has to look good. Everything about you, everything about us, should be glorifying God. And that is the glory that God wants. His church. Amen. Amen. He comes for His glory to be revealed. It has to be true worship. And guess what? When it comes to true worship, it is the worship that is led by the Spirit of God
Himself.
Nothing like you meditating upon which song can I worship again. The Spirit gives you a song to worship. The Spirit makes you to worship in your own words. The Spirit makes you to speak in new tongues. The Spirit makes you to kneel. The Spirit makes you to lift up your hands. The Spirit makes you to sleep down. The Spirit can make you speechless. The Spirit can make you appreciate whatever God is doing in your life. Sometimes we seem to be crying. As if we are not seeing the works of God. As if we are not doing what God is doing. And then we fail to worship. It's because our carnal mind has taken over. Never let your carnal mind to take over. Because this will only limit you to appreciate God. They will always limit you to do the will of God. Amen. Amen. There is obedience. When the glory of God is in the church, there is obedience. God bless you. There is obedience. Let me tell you, God does not want much from us. He only needs obedience. If only we can obey. If only we can listen to what the Spirit is telling the church. And we obey to it. We will never be rebellious. And when we are obeyed, we make God to promise that things that He knows that we need it in a year, in a month, in years. He promises those things. And those that He sees that we need them now, He gives them out there and
then.
Before you leave worshiping, before you leave praising, before even you leave the church, He has already given you what you need. For He knows what you need. And when you need it. So those you need now, He gives them to you. And those He knows that you may need them in the near future, He promises to give them to you. And if you don't faint,
you see those all promises being
fulfilled.
God does not lie. God does not change. Everything he promises, he fulfills. And that is the problem. If you can think about it, when God promises, when you are obedient, and then at a certain point you become disobedient. Your disobedience many times may not hinder God to fulfill what he promised. And when he fulfills them, you may think you're walking well,
right?
Yet you are perishing. So we should be careful. In the book of Exodus, chapter 33, verse 1 through 3. These are the children of Israel. There's something they did. They disobeyed
God.
When Moses came down from the mountain, he found them, made a calf to worship. Instead of worshiping God, who has been faithful and just to them, but just because they are not seeing Moses,
Musa.
Just because we are not seeing Apostle Juliet, and we decided to take on our own ways. After all, the vision bearer is not here. So let us take on our own ways. That's what they did. Someone there? Praise God.
Verse 1.
Mm.
Then the Lord said to Moses. Leave this place.
Leave this place.
You and the people you brought up out of Egypt. And go to the land I promised. On oath to Abraham.
Isaac,
and Jacob
says,
I will give it to your descendants. I will send an angel before you. And drive out the Canaanites.
Amorites.
Hittites,
Perizzites,
Hivites,
and the Jebusites.
Go up to the land flowing with milk and
go
honey.
Go up to the land flowing with milk and honey.
But I will not go with you. Because you are a stiff-necked people. And I might destroy you on the way.
Mukama nagamba Musanti. Mugende muli nyo kuva wano.
Mwengere musi.
Who got the people out of Egypt? These people cried to God. The Bible says that God
has
cried of the children of Israel. And he descended from the hand of Pharaoh. Now because they are disobedient, God doesn't see
them.
Moses and your people,
but what they miss,
that you got out of Egypt. When we disobey, we are no longer people of God. Calls us the people of Apostle Juliet. I do not know whether she can perfect all that we need. Whenever you disobey, you become a person of Apostle Juliet. you become a burden of your leader. God leaves you.
Uh-oh.
The disobedience. Hello.
Okay.
This means you no longer have provision. Because God is not getting anything from you. The glory wants to be manifested. You have not included yourself in manifesting it. Now he's asking you will do what I want to be done. Perhaps what you do, your pastor wants you to do them. Okay, be a person of your pastor. There are ministers that do that pastors or the apostles or leaders might see them. I appreciate you. You are achieved and I belong to the people you want to appreciate you.
Amen.
Amen. God wants his glory. If we disobey and refuse to hear, we are children of that person. And we thank God.
Apostle
never wants us to do our will.
He
always guides us to do what God wants us to do. And if it comes from God, it is the yearning of her that we might do that. No matter where from who it has passed, but if it has a confirmation that it comes from God, it's what we do. We are children of God.
Amen.
Amen.
Mugende zokodeyokoani.
Kuan. Mukama nagamba Musa. Mugende muri nyokuva wano.
Mugende muri nyokuva wano.
Wenabantu be wajja mu
misi.
Muyingire munsi gye nalayirira Ibrahim.
Isa
ne Yakobo
ne Yakobo
nga njogera nti
ndigiweza deyo
era ndituma malaika mu maso go
soko komao mukama yalayirira Abraham Isaac ne Jacob.
God promised Abraham Isaac and Jacob
enseno
this land
era mukujisubiza
and in his promising
yamugama ndigiweza deyo
I will give it to your descendants. Now God is showing that though they are disobedient, he is fulfilling the promise made with their forefathers. But the people is fulfilling it with are disobedient.
So ma?
Nga njogera nti
ndigiweza deyo
era ndituma malaika mu maso go era ndigoba mwomu Kanani
akube abakanani
omwamoli
abamoli
n'omukiti
n'abakiti
n'omuperisi
n'abaperisi
omukivi
n'omuyebusi
muse kulukuta n'amata
soko komeka. Instead of Mari Mabari Baji to them,
this land had inhabitants.
Nobody know Kunchibuamu.
They had to be driven out.
Kanavanava Katonabatu,
God might sit in this land.
A chocolate, Chichibachi, Chisokam.
What is yours shall be yours no matter
how you come and together with Simba.
You will build there, you will
want to buy them or rather while we are Simba.
Somebody built there and it is there.
Perhaps
the job you're supposed to do somebody's
there.
The times for you that God wants to
do. When your
seasons are
time,
no matter who is possessing, God promised it, so he shall put it to pass. Nothing is big. That gives me more courage. And what I don't have, I do not go
asking.
I don't have it because the situations of God. So that in seasons
I need to
but if my
shall be mine. It shall be yours. Don't lose hope and don't
fight.
God knows you more than you know yourself. God understands us.
God bless you.
Oh, come on, God. And he wants his glory to be manifested through you and me. And it shall be manifested. Because he that started the job, he will surely fulfill it. These nations are many. They are all there sitting.
And guess what? Pastor,
and they are sorcerers. They do not even know God. David says, I saw the wicked having more than he needed. Sometimes they scare us
when we see them.
They are just
mad.
When I saw their ending, you couldn't endure, you couldn't yearn for the lives they live.
Amen. So,
the third verse. He wants to drive all of these people out. That they go there. Where they're just enjoying the nation, the land. Nobody will fight them. Don't forget the people
who
have fought
for
God. God has given them an angel to lead them. To fight everything that is across them. They might enter the land and be free. But they are rebellious. The third verse. Munse kulukutanamata
ensi ekulukutanamata
n'omubisi gw'enjuki kubanga nze siri linnya wakati mu mmwe
naye nze siri linnya wakati mu mmwe Luganda bwe lugambye Luzungu lwagambye nze sigenda genda nammwe naye genda bba wa malayika abakulembera ababbira abantu abo nze sigenda genda nammwe nga Katonda.
I will not go with you as God. Kubanga
Banga
oli kwanga eririne nsige nkakanyavu.
Banga muli kwanga lya nsingo nkakanyavu muli bajemu.
Muli kubanga oli kwanga eririne nsige nkakanyavu. Nemo kukuzikiriza
nemo kukuzikiriza mukubo.
Mwenagera nawe ya kuzikiriza mukubo.
Mukama ekimwaula ku mujemu.
Why God separates himself from the rebellious person?
Kubanga rasa ningira kufa kwa mono.
Because he's not happy about the death of the rebellious
person.
One of the characters of God.
Ne wakubadde nga judo kusasira nechis.
God is full of mercy.
Katonda anyiga.
God is angered.
When
he is angry, he destroys.
Now
he says, I will not go with you because you are
jealous.
I might destroy you on the way. That's what I fear most.
When
he
is angry,
God fulfills all. Now listen. He has given you an angel that will hit your enemies. And where is taking you?
He's
doing a life that is good. For the Bible
said,
the land that flows with honey
and
milk. Nobody will hinder you. You do anything you want. You even have what you needed. 99% of today's born again. They will say,
we
need nothing from you. When is the angel leading us?
That
we might go and enjoy. Don't come, please send an angel. Not so. God will put you into that
land.
Nobody fights
you.
You have money. The way you want it. You drive the car you want. You fellowship when you want, when you don't feel like you don't
come.
You buy any cloth you want.
When
you want to go for vacation, you go into any nation you want. Yet God is not with you. Say, God, I don't need you.
After all,
if I go with you, since you have told me that you
are
destroyed, stay where you are. Let me go.
Come,
praise God. ekitiibwa kya Katonda
ekitalabisibwa
mu by'okola
newankubadde
nga Katonda yabikuwadde
kubanga
Katonda wamulege wajja na malayika naye bwe yamala okwerulira abalabe
n'addayo wa mukama kubanga
malayika ye mugongo ekimutumidde okukola
kyakolaamala
okikolakatonda yeka yabeera naffe mu bire
birungikatonda
yabeera naffe mu muliro ne mu mazzi amangi katonda yabeera naffe mu mbeera
zonna
bamalayika tebatabalagidde tebajja kukola
do what they have not been commanded to do. They will look at you and wait
to
make a call to your embassy
above,
to command them.
If
he doesn't, they will look at you. Praise the Lord. Abantu bwe baawulira ebigambo ebyo
abaana ba Isirayiri bano newankubadde nga bajeemu bwe baawulira ebigambo bino
ebibi
ebibi kubanga bibi mukama abanza atya okutagenda nabo
ne banakuwala
ne wataba muntu
eyayambala ebyobuyonjo bye mukama n'agamba Musa nti
gamba abaana ba Isirayiri
muli ggwanga
eririna ensinga enkakanyavu
mbeera kulinnya wakati mu ggwe
newankubadde akaseera akatono
Nandikuzikiriza.
Kale kaakano.
Yambula ebyobuyonjo byo. Ndyokende ntegeere.
Wenakukola.
Olw'omukaaga. Abaana ba Isirayiri.
Beyambula ebyobuyonjo byabwe.
Okuva mu lusozi Kolebu.
Okweyongerayo.
Musa natwalanga eweema n'agisimba ebweru w'olusiisira walako n'olusiisira n'agiyita eweema ey'okusisinkanirangamu
era buli eyanoonyanga Mukama
n'afulumanga n'agenda mu weema ey'okusisinkanirangamu eyali ebweru w'olusiisira era Musa bwe yafulumanga
n'agenda mu weema
abantu bonna ne bagolokokanga ne bayimirira buli muntu mu mulyango gw'eweema ye n'atunuuliranga Musa okutuusa bwe yamalanga okuyingira mu weema
Mukama ibasiwe.
Praise the Lord.
Abantu
people
newankubadde nga bali bajeemu
disobedient
bagamba Musa,
they told Moses,
gamba mukama yatumye,
tell that Lord that has sent you,
bwabanga tagenda naffe,
if he's not going with us,
kale katufire mu ggongo,
let us die in the desert,
naffe tetulina gye tulaga,
we are also not going anywhere.
Kama ibasi.
Praise the Lord.
Mukama bwaba tali naffe,
if God is not with us,
tekitugasa ne bwe tubanga tulina ebyenkana bijja.
Even though we have all that we need.
Amen.
Amen.
Kati ekitiibwa kya Katonda bwe kyagenda naffe.
Now if the glory of God doesn't go with us,
tuba tetugasa.
We are not of use.
Kati Katonda ayagala okulaba ekkanisa ye ng'egasa.
So God wants to see his church useful.
Era okugasa kwayo.
And that use of the church,
egasa erina ekitiibwa.
It is useful when it has the glory of God. Somebody whose honor is honored. Somebody who is not honorable is not respected. Now the Church of Christ has been minimized or despised and spoken many words
about it,
as born against like this, as they do this and that, as they eat this and that, as they have put peace on us and
that. Because
the glory of God has not been in church. Perhaps that's the reason it is not respected. But if the glory of God is in the church, the church shall be respected. It is up to you and me to make sure the glory of God is manifested
in
all that we do. That we might not do anything else as we want, but as God wants. That way the church of God will
be.
And if the church is honored, you shall be honored
too.
Nations shall run to you. People run to a born again if they carry the glory
of God.
Not that whoever gets born again, not that everyone who becomes born again is born again. But we alone that carry the glory of God. Whether they like it or not, they
born
again. Because the glory of God is upon their life. And so they've become honored. To you that have been seeing yourself, you that have been despised, it has come to an end. Make sure that the glory of God on our church shall be respected.
God bless you. Heavenly Father, we thank you. Indeed, you are God. Who loves us. You are our Father. You are our friend. You are our everything. Even the weak, they are strong in you. So Father, we declare today that we are strong, we are wise, we are righteous, and we are going to reveal the glory of your church on this latter day. Father, we surrender to you as clean and ready vessels to be used by you for your will to be done and the glory of the church to be revealed. Let us be the demonstration ground to all the churches in Uganda and in the rest of the world. Then we are going to be the change that God wants to see in the church in these late days. We thank you, Lord, for your using us. We thank you, God, for your taking us where you want us to go. We are so grateful that you love us. Father, take all the glory. All of us. We are not just giving you part of our hearts, but all of our hearts. Dwell in them and live. In Jesus' name.